What is a network frame preamble and how does it work? Why do we need it? Well, I'm going to give you the simple answer to those questions right now. For the best startup and newbie networking concepts ever taught, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to be notified when I post a new video once a week. So I talked about the portions of a network frame in another video, but I left the preamble out of that video, and for several reasons, but primarily because when you study textbooks on computer networking, they will always tell you the preamble is not part of the frame, but when you actually sit down to take a certification test, the testing material and questions will oftentimes make the assumption the preamble is part of the frame. So, for all intents and purposes, you can look at it any way you want to, but if you're asked a question and you're taking a test, I would suggest that you consider the preamble and the starter frame delimiter as part of the frame, and we'll just leave it at that. Now, it's good to know what the preamble of a frame looks like, and the two biggest reasons it gets placed at the start of each frame. I want to show you and tell you what those two reasons are for using the preamble first, then show you what a basic Ethernet frame preamble looks like. An Ethernet preamble is used at the beginning of a frame on a computer network for two primary reasons. Number one, the first reason is that it is to give the computer or the device receiving the incoming frame a kind of a heads up that, hey, there's a frame coming right after this, so get ready. And secondly, the second reason is that it is to provide a 5 megahertz clock timing with the ones and the zeros in the preamble to allow the receiving computer or device to lock the incoming bitstream. So it's kind of to get the timing down on what is actually involved in the frame before the destination MAC address actually shows up on that network cable, on that interface, on, you know, whatever portion of that frame is coming in. Now, those may sound fairly simple, but if you don't have a preamble, a receiving machine may actually miss or misunderstand the frame altogether, and it may misunderstand everything that follows the preamble and not actually read it or understand it correctly on its own network interface card. So that's the reason behind that. Feel free to leave a comment below if you've already taken a certification exam and you encountered a question on a certification exam about the preamble, or if you have any additional questions about it, and I'll be more than happy to respond as quickly as I can. So those are the two reasons the preamble is used and needed. Let's take a look at what a preamble actually looks like and how it's made up. An Ethernet preamble is made up of 7 bytes of alternating ones and zeros, and it actually looks like this. It is immediately followed by the start frame delimiter, better known as the SFD, the acronym for it, which is, the SFD is 1 byte long, and it ends in 1-1. The start frame delimiter, or start of frame delimiter, is the real heads up to the receiving device that, hey, important frame information is coming immediately after me, so get ready, receiving device. The SFD looks similar to one of the bytes in the actual preamble, but it looks like this, because it ends in 1-1 instead of 1-0. So technically, the frame preamble overall looks like this. It's 8 bytes overall, including the SFD, 7 bytes of ones and zeros, ones and zeros, then you have the last byte, which is the SFD, ending in 1-1. Again, and I cannot emphasize this enough, you will read in networking textbooks that the preamble, including the SFD, is not actually part of the frame, but on most certification tests, really most networking tests in general, the questions you may get will 9 times out of 10 assume the preamble and SFD are indeed part of the frame. Easiest thing to do with it is know it, know what it does and why it's needed, and you should be able to get any related questions correct about it, as well as learn to recognize it when you're looking at a frame capture. I've put together a series of videos that go further in depth about Ethernet frames and how to use them and recognize them on a computer network, as well as a free subnetting cheat code, little subnetting mini course that will help you score up to 30% higher on just about any certification exam that can be learned, and you can learn this in 1 minute or less. Also, if you want to join a community of networkers just like you that are learning about the technologies and getting started, I have a secret society where I have up-to-date networking know-how to help you navigate and get started right down this sometimes tricky career or business path in life. If you like this video, please let me know by liking it below, subscribe to my channel, and share this video with your fellow networkers, and comment below with helpful if this video helped you.